Hello everybody, mega goal number one, 11 form meaning function, pages 44 and 45. Let's take a look at the objectives. The first one, the present simple versus present progressive. Number two, present progressive for the future. Number three, time expression for the future. Number five, make and respond to suggestions. Number six, information questions. Number seven, make up tag questions. طبعا لو تشوفون في اشياء كثيره راح نغطيها اليوم. راح نتكلم عن المضارع البسيط وكذلك راح نقارن بينه وبين المضارع المستمر. راح نتكلم عن المضارع المستمر واستخدامه في المستقبل. راح نتكلم عن يعني عبارات او كلمات دلاليه تدل على الوقت في المستقبل. راح نكون كذلك اقتراحات وراح نرد عليها وبرضو راح نسأل أسئلة عامة. وآخر حاجة راح نتكلم عن tag questions. Now let's start. Please move on to page number 44 and 45 and let's start. خلونا نبدأ. So the first thing we will be talking about, أول شيء راح نتكلم عن the present simple versus the present progressive. The present simple مثل ما أنتم عارفين اللي هو المضارع البسيط, وال present progressive عبارة عن المضارع المستمر. طبعا متى نستخدم المضارع البسيط؟ We usually use the present simple when we want to talk about habits or routine. لما نبي نتكلم عن عادة أو شيء روتيني نستخدم عادة الفعل المضارع. لكن لما نتكلم عن actions occurring now or for a temporary situation, لما نبغى نتكلم عن مثلا حدث حصل الآن أو مؤقت نستخدم وعندنا أمثلة. طبعا خلينا نشوف أول حاجة present simple, he lives here, she lives here, it lives here. فالمفرد ياخذ الاس. اوكي ياخذ الاس. they, we, you, I live here. طبعا مع الجمع ومع they, we, you, I. روتين او عاده او حقيقه. am is are. وانتو عارفين طبعا كل واحد شنو ياخذ مع الverb ing. for example she is working in the UK now or he is working in the UK now. so is working هنا المضارع المستمر present progressive which is referring to something occurring now حصل يحصل الآن or temporary أو مؤقت. So this is mainly the main difference, الفرق الأساسي between the present simple and the present progressive. الفرق الأساسي بينهم في الformation وكذلك في المعنى. Now let's move on. Sometimes أحيانا نستخدم the present progressive for the future. نستخدم المضارع المستمر لكن في للإشارة إلى المستقبل. طبعا كذا أراجعكم مرة ثانية. The present progressive يتكون من be plus verb ing. طبعا نستخدم the present progressive for the future to talk about arrangements and scheduled events in the future. لما نتكلم عن يعني شيء مرتب له أو شيء مجدول له لكن متى في المستقبل. So present progressive is used sometimes for the future, نستخدم أحيانا للمستقبل, when we are talking about something which is arranged or scheduled in the future. For example, نشوف, they are flying to Dubai tonight. طبعا لو تلاحظون الجملة في أي زمن صح في the present progressive, بس إنه أنا أشير إلى المستقبل, to Dubai tonight. طبعا هذا الشيء تم جدولته أو تم التخطيط له مسبقا. خلينا نشوف how to make up question using طبعا or questions in the present progressive. طبعا باختصار كيف أكون سؤال؟ أنا حطيت لكم القاعدة اللي هي مفروض تكون قاعدة عامة بس أهم شيء تكون صيغة السؤال صحيحة. المعنى إنه مثلا ممكن تختلف طريقة الأسئلة لكن صيغة السؤال صحيحة. anyways now let's take a look. so the WH B معروف إن B المقصود بها is are am. subject اللي هي الفاعل والverb ing. now I have a sentence. he's flying to Dubai at 9 o'clock in the morning. So what I want to ask about is at 9 o'clock in the morning. طبعا لما بسأل عن هذا الشيء معناته إني راح أستخدم when لأني أبغى أسأل عن الزمن. So نطبق القاعدة when. Okay, verb to be here is. The subject is he flying to Dubai. So when he is flying to Dubai, obviously he is flying to Dubai at 9 o'clock in the morning. طبعا مثل ما أقول لكم دائما, I do not include the answer in my question. ما أضمن الإجابة في السؤال. So this is mainly about هذا طبعا الشيء اللي أخذناه عن the present progressive for the future. Now let's move on to the next part, الجزء الثاني, which is time expressions for the future. طبعا سهل جدا, شنو العبارات التعبيرية للزمن في المستقبل. Now as you could see here, I have listed them in a question format. يعني سويتها في مثل صيغة الأسئلة مثل ما موجودة عندكم بالكتاب. What are you going to do tomorrow? So tomorrow is one of the expressions that is used for the future. I'm going to visit the Museum of Science and Technology. Will you go to school next week? Next week. Yes, she will. Okay, so next week is one also of the expressions that is used for the future. Are you sitting examinations next month? Yes, I am. So here next month as well. So all of these expressions, time expressions, tomorrow, next week, next month, next year, all of them are used to express or for the future. Now let's move on to the next part, which is make and respond to suggestions. طبعا what do I mean by suggestions? Suggestions اللي هو عادة الاقتراحات. خلاص مثلا I want to suggest something that you do something. اقترح. Now right now we will discuss how to make these suggestions and how to respond to them. كيف نرد عليهم. We have three ways in which we can form suggestions. ثلاث طرق. You just have to memorize them by heart and apply them. Very easy. سهل جدا. فقط تحفظونهم وتطبقونهم. So number one, I can say let's. Number two, how about. وطبعا لما نستخدم how about يجي بعدها الverb ing. Number three, why don't we or why don't you. طبعا why don't we لما نكون أنا مثلا مع شخص آخر وننوي نسوي مثلا شغلة معينة. Why don't we لما أنا أقترح على شخص آخر. Now I have here a suggestion which is go shopping. So if I wanna suggest this to a friend to do this, I can say number one, let's go shopping. Let's go shopping. Oops. Let's go shopping. And طبعا of course this is a full stop. Number two, how about as here? How about okay, طبعا as we said here previously, مثل ما ذكرتكم الverb plus ing going. Shopping, all right, and of course a question mark. Number three, why don't we or why don't you go shopping? Okay, so this is mainly how to make up a suggestion. كيف نكون اقتراح. And right now we will discuss how do we respond to these suggestions. فلازم when we respond we have to be as well polite. لازم نكون مهذبين. Now if you refuse or if you decline this either رفضت مثلا or if you do not want to do this suggestion, you can say we can't or I can't. And then you have to provide a reason. لازم تعطي سبب. So let's go shopping. I can't, I have an exam. We can't, I have an appointment. Now, if you agree, okay, and you would like to do this, to have a go with this suggestion, إن الواحد يبغى يطبقه مثلا يبغى يسويه, you can say, great idea, let's do it. Yes, why not? That sounds great. So, ممكن نجاوب أي طريقة نحبها, سواء في الرفض أو في الإجاب, يعني في الموافقة. Now let's move on to the next one, which is information questions. Information question اللي هي مثلا الأسئلة العامة اللي مثلا what is your name, where are you from, how old are you, وهكذا. So mainly طبعا information question القاعدة تقول إنه we start with the WH word, the helping verb, the auxiliary verb اللي هي الفعل المساعد, ممكن يكون well, do, did, is, are, والsubject اللي هو الفاعل, وكذلك بعدها يكون المين فيرب الفعل الأساسي. هذه القاعدة العامة بشكل عام. Now the question word depends on what we want to ask about. تعتمد على اللي نبغى نسأل عنه. Okay. So here, if we want to ask about time, we use when. If we want to ask about a place, we use where. If we want to ask about something, we say what. And if we want to ask about which thing, which, أي واحد. How is to ask about how something is done, and why if you want to ask about the reason. Now we have here questions. Now, what are you going to do this summer? What are you going to do this summer? Now, I'll probably travel. I'll probably travel. Okay, so طبعا الإجابة طبعا نتبه إن لما نسأل سؤال في المضارع يكون إجابة عادة في المضارع, في الماضي الإجابة عادة في الماضي وهكذا. So this one is asking about future plans. Now, I'll probably travel. Where will you go? I'll go to Najran. How will you get there? Maybe I'll drive. طبعا هنا لو تلاحظون, if you have realized that when we are using well, sometimes we use probably or maybe. ممكن نستخدم ممكن ومحتمل. Probably or maybe. This is to express mainly doubt or uncertain. Okay, this is to express doubt or uncertain. يعني أنا استخدم مثلا هنا مثلا maybe I'll drive. من الممكن أني أنا يعني أقود السيارة anyways, or I'll probably travel. ممكن أني أسافر. ف this is to express something that you are not sure about, مو متأكد من, أو يعني تشك أنك تسوي, you are doubting it, or probably you are uncertain, غير متأكد. So this is when we right now what we have talked about, which is information question. Now let's move on to the next one, and this is the last thing on our list. آخر حاجة في القائمة اللي عندنا, which is tag question. Tag question is very easy, سهل جدا, فقط تعرفون الفكرة الرئيسية. First, let me explain to you. خلينا أشرح لكم معنى tag question. Tag question is usually sentences that ends with a sentence that ends with a question. جملة تنتهي بسؤال. طبعاً yes or no question. And we usually use these types of questions to check information. عشان نشيك على المعلومات يعني. For example, she is a teacher, isn't she? So this is a tag question. Now I'm gonna give you a brief يعني summary يعني ملخص عن tag question, بعدين بنطبق. We use it to check information, and we use an auxiliary verb to be, to have, to do, well, the models. طبعا احنا نستخدمها عشان نشيك على الايش, على المعلومات, ونستخدم معها الافعال المساعدة. طبعا شنو الفعل المساعد؟ verb to be, verb to have, verb to do. ونستخدم subject personal nouns, I, she, he, it, you, they, we. طبعا راح أوضح لكم بعدين لما نطبق شو المقصود بهذا. طبعا عندي نوعين, اللي إذا كانت الجملة affirmative, إذا كانت الجملة مثبتة, فالسؤال يكون negative. التاج question يكون negative, يعني موجبة منفية. Okay, طبعا شو المقصود negative? Not. Now, when the statement or the sentence is negative, we use usually an affirmative tag. خلاص. She is a teacher, isn't she? I am not from Saudi. She is not from Saudi Arabia, is she? So this is an example of tag question when it is affirmative and when it is negative. خلينا نشوف. Now, let's take a look at the first one. She will go to Paris. طبعا هذه الجملة affirmative. خلاص, so I'll have a comma. She will go to Paris. طبعا مثل ما قلنا السؤال يكون منفي. قلنا نستخدم auxiliary verb والsubject pronoun. auxiliary verb هنا well. طبعا المنفي بيكون want. والهنا personal subject will be she. طبعا don't forget to end it with a question mark. She will go to Paris, won't she? Now, most people use their cars to get around the city. طبعا ممكن تسألوا تقولون لي وين ال personal subject, وين ال auxiliary. راح أوضح لكم. أول حاجة الجملة هذه affirmative. طبعا لما يكون ما عندي فعل مساعد هنا استخدم verb to do، وانتو عارفين do و does في المستقبل the present اللي هو المضارع، اوكي، واستخدم did في حالة الماضي. عارفين ان do مع الجمع و does مع المفرد عادة. طبعا most people use their cars to get around the city. I need an auxiliary، احتاج الى فعل مساعد. ما عندي فعل مساعد، ابي اشوف اول شيء. طبعا most people جمع، اوكي، use في اي زمن المضارع واضح، فهنا راح استخدم don't طبعا لانها لازم تكون منفي. طبعا هنا I need a personal subject. personal subject شنو اللي يشير الى most people؟ they. so don't they and of course the question. حين فهمتوا شو القصد ان احنا استخدم auxiliary verb واستخدم personal subject. okay now let's move on to the next one. she teaches English. so right now this is an affirmative statement. okay I need an auxiliary and a subject pronoun. طبعا هنا teaches في اي زمان؟ في المضارع. طبعا شنو استخدم؟ does. طبعا هنا we'll have a comma. okay so I don't have a space. doesn't will personal subject she. alright now let's move on to the next one. she went to London last year. so here went in the past. طبعا الجملة affirmative. okay so I'm gonna have here a comma. she went to London last year. طبعا I don't have an auxiliary فبستخدم do did sorry do does or did ماضي فبستخدم did. واضح؟ هنا منفي راح يكون السؤال مثل ما قلنا القاعدة didn't والpersonal subject she. she went to London last year didn't she. so this is mainly to check information. now let's move on to the last two examples. آخر مثالين طبعا اللي راحتوا إنهم راح يكونون منفيين فالtag question راح يكون affirmative. now they didn't go to Riyadh. طبعا I will have comma. راح طبعا أنا ما أقدر يعني عشان الوقت ما راح أكتب السؤال يعني أكتب الجملة مرة ثانية فهنا لازم أحط comma بعدين شنو أسوي did and they. okay طبعا مثل ما قلت لكم لو ما يكون عندي personal subject أشوف شنو personal subject اللي يشير لها. you aren't from Riyadh. طبعا هنا I'm gonna have are you. okay and this is mainly what we are so this is mainly what we are supposed to discuss. شنو الأشياء اللي مفروض نناقشها. and right now we have reached the end of the lesson. I hope that you found it really beneficial and useful. don't forget to subscribe, share this video with your friend, and if you have a question regarding this lesson or of any kind you can just leave it in the comment box below. بس نمر على الأهداف بسرعة اللي هو present simple versus present progressive. present progressive for the future, time expression for the future. number five, make and respond to suggestions, information questions and make up tag questions. طبعا بس قبل ما أختم بقول لكم إني أنا راح أترك قناة التليجرام في description box below وراح أنزل فيها التلخيصات. طبعا ممكن ما انزل التلخيص مباشرة بس انه I promise you that I will اللي هو للقاعدة هذه بدل ما تسوون تصوير للشاشة راح انزل لكم بإذن الله الملخصات. and till next time have a good one.